Well, that was an interesting start to the stream. Both the hair and the technical issues. I figured you probably didn't want to see me in a ponytail today.
Whoa.
Oh god, hello.
Whoa.
Hello, Wolfcraft. Thank you for the host. Oh, how are you doing? I've had quite the time in the last 15 minutes. Also, well, I need to check out a million things. I had to edit the stream last week, and from that, I realized many an issues with it that I have hopefully started to change. For a start, we have a microphone. We've always had one, obviously. But now it's on the left side, or my left, and it's on an arm, which I had just buried in a cupboard. I thought I had to buy a new one. I bought one like September 2019 or something. Don't know why I didn't use it, but now the microphone is going to be real loud and real close to me. Although it does say that I am peaking a bit, so maybe I'll turn off my gain. But I did notice this is a reaction to the fact that last week we had very, very, very quiet audio. The reasoning for that was because I had an old setup in the cupboard that had a very loud computer in a very small room. Still the same computer, kind of. Yeah, same computer, but it still was. I needed to make noise suppression a thing on my microphone so that it wouldn't pick up the buzzing in the background. When I moved to this setup, you can't hear the computer as much, hopefully, but I also had the noise suppression on so much that you couldn't hear like a third of the words I said, which is a major pain to try and edit over. So now, mic is closer up, I've turned up the volume, and I've turned way down the volume of our music. I need to check though officially in a little bit how our audio sounds, because my god, people said last week, oh, the audio's perfect when I added like 3 extra decibels in the voice. It was far from perfect, my dudes. I was way off. Anyway, hello, Lewis Gamer. And, well, yeah, that's... Oh, I thought that was the guy who followed. It wasn't. But, hello, Lewis Gamer, anyway. You got a little thing pop up, so hi. And also, Scalion, thank you for the follow. But yes, there were some technical issues last time that I'm hopefully ironing out today. How does this audio sound? Like, is my voice peaking too much? Is it nice and loud? Is this actually audible? For a start. Actually, I'm just gonna listen to it myself. Excuse the echo. I liked that. As another thing, we had a guy show up last week. Ali Ab, I remember you because I had to watch your interaction twice. You might not be here right now, but you will be at some point. Hopefully. You complained that you could only watch the stream at 1080 P 60 frames per second. That's the source that I was outputting it to, and you couldn't downscale it on Twitch. That is a Twitch issue. For whatever reason, despite being, I would assume, a multi-million dollar company, there's only so many resources that can be spent on, I guess there are millions of streamers, so maybe that's why it makes sense. Only so much that they can do for the website, so at peak times, like apparently 8 o'clock in the afternoon in the UK on a Wednesday, there are so many higher priority streamers out and about that the options to downscale a stream is prioritized to those at the top, and it hasn't reached, you know, me at the bottom with like 30 viewers, which is pretty damn good anyway, but you know, whatever. So to get around that, you have to output the stream at 720p instead of 1080. So now, if you have a look at the sources in the little corner, if you're watching this on Twitch, which you will be, oh no, you could be on... Anyway, you should hopefully... Actually, let me check it myself. You should hopefully... Yeah, I can see it. I've got 720, 60, 480, 360, and 160, if you really want to go for that high-quality magic. Bit weird. To be a better streamer when you're small, you have to make a lower quality stream. But that's just how it is sometimes. It sounds perfect like your vids. Thank you. I assume you're talking about my audio. I appreciate that. It was okay, not unbearable or anything. Still a fun stream. That's fair, Kawhi. That's fair enough. Trying to edit it for someone who's like going to watch on YouTube,
I really didn't like how it sounded. But hopefully this is much better. I can get way up in your face and... Yeah. how would that sound? It did say it peaked. Way up in your face and... Yeah, I was. Even then, though, I mean, it does peak. It doesn't, like, hurt anyone's ears. Maybe it does, but I don't know. Whatever. I'm happy to be too loud this week as the alternative of not even being able to be picked up on the mic. I'm way worse off, so that's how we're going to go. Hello, Mitchell. Hello, Lols is game. Hello, Aaron the Pro. Audio's fine this time around. Fantastic. Similarly, did I do it earlier with the music? It doesn't matter. The music on this has all been turned down. I have had a lovely time recently. We were playing Rolled Out last week, and you may have noticed there were a few glitches in the whole thing. And when I was watching movies, there was artifacting, there was freezings, there was nothing I could fix what was going on. And that's because there's an issue on my computer that I've had for months that hadn't really made a major impact until that Wednesday, where I have 100% disk usage randomly on my computer, and when it gets to that point, it freezes until it goes below 100% disk usage or something. I scoured the internet to find a fix, went through a million different things until I eventually found like 7 resolutions. I went through the first 5, nothing changed. Went to step 6, and it said, you can fix this if you reset your computer, and you will lose everything except your files, and it will take 27 hours. So I lost my Friday or my Saturday, whatever day I did that. I just completely zonked out. I got to do no editing. I got behind on all of the things I was trying to juggle. Come back the next day. Hadn't fixed it. So, that's fun. So what we did instead is then there was the 7th resolution, which was just, oh, you've got to disable Superfetch on your computer. And I'm like, I don't have Superfetch. What is this Superfetch? Turns out for Windows 10, they renamed it to just like System Mains. Okay. I disable it in like a minute. Fixed. I wasted a 27-hour scan across my entire hard drive for something that could be fixed in 5 minutes. Except 5 days, maybe 4 days have passed till we come to today. It came back. 100% disk. It was fixed. So I've looked online. It turns out this is an error on Windows 10. And there's no fix. You can just delay something, you can disable it, and then 3 days later it will come back even though something's disabled. It's just something you have to live with. But my freezings have stopped. I'm finding one issue in the one Premiere profile we are just about to watch. But otherwise, yeah, pain, basically. But we're gonna give it a go. I am basically very much into this next phase of streaming we're doing. It is still just going to be nice and casual, one a week, but I am officially counting this now, as I like to think. I imagine this is going to be a long-term thing. So this is now officially season 1 of Dazz videos and Dazz reviews streams. Previously, the 2-month session we did in 2020, the November-December slot, that can be season 0. And any other streams before that, either doesn't count as a stream because it was part of a Let's Play, or it's stream -1 and -2 and -3. We're now officially on stream season 1, and there is some systems that I am setting up in place. For a start, this season will last for about 6 months, because in 6 months' time, we're moving out. We are getting out of this place, and we're moving to Brighton. So that Brighton location will be season 2. Something will upgrade, and we'll sort of keep going as things go from there. There is another trait that I'll be introducing later on in this stream to be an effect of season 1. But for now, let's get into the films. Every stream starts with film content. We don't have many films to talk about, and we also don't have that much time. The second slot of this stream is going to take precedent and start in 45 minutes. So, with just 45 minutes to go, hope you're all ready and knowing, and you remember what's trending right now? I'll show you myself. It's Netflix. What a surprise, eh? But there is a trailer. This is... We're gonna... I'm jumping around a bunch. There's one trailer I want to watch and analyze properly. Haven't seen it, so this will be our reaction. The reason for it is because we actually made a video on it on YouTube before. And it got delayed, as it always does. I've mentioned it in passing over the months. I am invested in it. So let's see how things are doing over in the world of Connected. Also known as The Mitchells and the Machines. Never mind. I have to restart the whole program for it to play in my headphones. And probably play at all in Streamlabs. Pain. I have had so many technical errors in this last week, it is not funny. It will be in hindsight, but my god. Why Brighton? A lot of elements of my life are leaning towards Brighton. Brighton is the YouTuber hub, so that's a good start for my career. I'm also a comedian who's part of a comedy sketch group. We perform sometimes at the Brighton Fringe Festival, so that lines up quite nicely there. I have school friends who I have always kept kind of in contact with. They live in Brighton. The air and the coastal region is good for my skin and my lungs, considering I have eczema all over my joints and asthma hiding in my lungs somewhere. Now, hopefully, this time, we are delayed nicely enough. Shall we get into The Mitchells and the Machines? No, it's still not playing out of my, speakers. I know how to fix it again. I just need to go into preferences, but my God, I am living a comedy now. I don't even need to go to the Brighton Fringe Festival next year. Like this doesn't. The Mitchells and the Machines. Originally, also, this is really, really, really loud. Why are you so loud? Why have I got so many technical issues? Originally, this was called Connected. It got changed back. It used to be The Mitchells vs. The Machines. Then they changed it to Connected. Then I guess people didn't like that name. So they've changed it back to The Mitchells vs. The Machines. Remember this thing? We're going into this. My God, play. Wait. They're coming.
Is that a burnt orange 1993 station wagon? Or is it...
Okay, it's the family, the 3D CG Sony film we've been waiting for ages.
Let me introduce myself. I'm Katie. I'm sort of a weirdo. My parents haven't figured me out yet. To be fair, it took
it's the strange boomer versus Gen Z film with the brother who has a really freakily low-pitched voice.
All of us, really.
How about we put our phones down and we can make 10 seconds. Family eye contact. Starting now.
With a scene we've already seen because it got delayed, I guess. It's from the. I'm actually really excited for this, honestly.
Good family picture in years because you two are always arguing. For my family.
About. You'd think it'd be an interesting family drama of trying to get. You know, understand your kids in this modern technological world. But there's an apocalypse in the middle of the whole thing! To tell the story of technology bad? I certainly hope not.
What would a functional family do?
I hope it comes up. Oh. Well, that's new.
So we just do that, right?
That was not the best punchline to that, I'll be honest.
I gave you all boundless knowledge, and you treated me like this.
Oh. Wow, this is literally like the dog episode of Rick and Morty. I hope that it becomes a matter of like they use the good parts of technology, you know? Be a bit more dimensional. Yeah.
Everything with the computer chip is
alive. I liked that joke. Okay.
What makes us great. Hold on a second.
What's a Furby?
Oh no, they got a product placement in there. I'm gonna quickly check my audio. Oh no, they got a product.
That is really pretty quiet. I could probably do with turning that up a little bit. You disagree? Tell me if I've ruined it now. I feel like a scriptwriter just found the memes around Furbies online. Yeah. Cool. In that case, how was that last part on the audio? Just to check before I do that, because obviously we're going to be talking about other trailers soon. So I'd like to get that fixed. I've done everything from scratch. From having to reset my computer, I've had to redo all of my... I had a whole stream deck full of music. It's all gone. I've had to redo it. And I've got one page of stuff. The trailer was so muffled. Okay. You are allowed to tell me at the beginning of a trailer. Because, you know, you just had to sit through and watch that whole thing with barely any audio. Alright, I turned it up by 10. Let's do another test then, alright? Tell me how this sounds. Challenge. Now is this... Okay, well you want a quiet
probably
bit.
Probably the robot apocalypse.
Is this too loud? Alongside my voice? Does my voice get lost? Is it fine? I can just answer myself. Okay, that is the perfect level, which is, what gain is that? That is -8, really? Wow, that's really, really loud. Why is Streamlabs and like telling how loud something is completely skewed at the moment? I don't know what's going on there, but okay, whatever. Mitchell's and the Machines, I'm actually really invested in. I am very conflicted on it because I don't know how they're going to play with that technologies element. But while I'm here, let me do what I did last week and cut all the shots up, and then we'll try and slather it all into chronological order. It's what we did on YouTube. I don't think I'll be making a second YouTube video on it, but I will make it a little stream thing. So yeah. The movie does seem quite good, though, like a quirky, almost adult-aimed family film, but in a good way. Yeah, absolutely. I really like the style. Kind of getting behind Sony Pictures. Sometimes they make good stuff. Yeah. Obviously, this has been sort of lost in a hiatus and waiting for a good release for a while now. Did they say a release date at the end of that, actually? Have a look. April 30th. Wow, that's soon, isn't it? That's... Wait, as in, it's in 2 weeks? Oh, it's on Netflix. It's a Netflix movie? Is that a change on, like, the... That's strange. That's very, very strange. Lewis Gamer, do I want a stream upgrade? I don't know what... It depends what you're... What are you offering here? Oh, dear. Maybe? I don't know. I'm day two into this, essentially. It's just I've literally just reset my computer, so everything's redone itself, you know? So, we'll see. Mitchell's vs. the Machines definitely has charming animation. Yeah, I like it. I like the Sony design. You like the name Mitchell's vs. the Machines? Yeah, it reminds you of Meet the Robinsons. I see that, yeah. I did think Connected seems like the kind of Pixar-y... Well, Pixar does one words. It's a very, like, modern-day title. Mitchell vs. Machines has a nice roll-off to it, I find. Netflix bought the movie? That... Okay, that makes sense. Alright then. Right, let's get into some clips. So now I've made a little addition on... You're not going to hear much audio, but I'm also not to play much music for the sake of my editor. It's easier that way. We've got loads of different clips for each individual shot, just prepped and done in advance. This, okay, so first things first, this whole apocalypse element we actually saw, I should have gotten the original trailer, excuse me, I didn't. This is like, we see this shot before, it's like a wider shot of car parks, there's fire everywhere, it's quite late into the apocalypse, of course, because, you know, the robots are here, so that would kind of make sense, fair enough. And then apparently, I guess the family have got their stuff together, so they're gonna whack them over. This is its own separate shot. I would be surprised. In fact, look, they're inside a tunnel right now. How's he looking out there without a tunnel? That makes no sense. Okay, sure. Following that, yep, they get bowling balled, which does not really make me laugh too much, but I'm sure it will to some kids out there, I guess. Following that, oh, cool. Speeding away, this could be, yes, we've seen this before as well. There's a ramp segment in the original trailer. In fact, like, it's the kind of poster child for the whole thing. If I get it up, If I get up, yeah, Mitchell's versus machines. I could spell. Literally, the iconic imagery is, there it is. Will it show up on this? Is this display capture? I certainly hope so. There you go. It's them like crashing with a car up in the air. Yeah, that is literally the end of this scene. You know, they're being chased along the thing, and then they go up a ramp. So chase scene makes sense. Fighting with a shoe. What is this? What's going on here?
The only people who can save the world.
Okay, just struggling to fight. All right, makes sense. Why do you have a high-pitched voice now? That's not how you sound. You sound like an adult, like in your bedroom. This is your voice. It's unnatural, but it's there.
Hi, would you like to talk to me about dinosaurs?
No. Hi, would you like to talk to me about dinosaurs? I'm 30 in a 6-year-old's body. That's really strange, you know? The Mitchells Ava the Machines rolls off the tongue like it's always sunny in the Philadelphia. Yeah, absolutely. I get that. Oops. Give me a second. Don't mind me. I look this. Cool. Don't mind me. Oh, I've got such a small like window here that I can't get it. There we go. And now I can actually see what's going on. Huzzah. Can you play any games soon? Absolutely. We are playing games in half an hour, hence why I'm half kind of getting through this one trailer. Yes. Hello, Red Panda. Thank you for joining us. We're in the middle of this wonderful thing. So, all right. That makes sense. End of a po- Actually, you know what? I feel like this kind of says things in order, right? So, like, this is, like, some big money shot of, like, oh, there's our family. Mid-crisis. Sure. Yeah, we get an introduction of, wow, she's really into puppets. I remember this was from her, like, she wants to get into art university across the country. I feel like this might be chronological. She's an artsy person. She's putting her poor dog into a skater outfit, I guess. Also, a new thing I've made, by the way. Hope you enjoy this. I have an ability to now just, boop, disappear. So now you can see if there's something behind me, you know. Oh, there. Now you can see it. So, a little thing I just wanted to show off because I feel like I might not get to use it. This might just be in chronological order. If that's the case, I might just skip it. Like, yep, the family have their dynamics. Yep, talking to everyone and the dinosaurs, sure. They put in a joke in here for the audiences and the adults to laugh at, or oh, maybe it'll get changed now the internet's found out. They don't like the dad and his boomery ways. Yeah, and then, you know, they disagree. Yeah, I think this is just pretty straightforward, right? Yeah, okay, so they're in this shop when it goes down. We see how that all plays out a bit more directly now. Apocalypse rises. Everyone doesn't know what to do. There's the super perfect family that I actually really like the joke of. Yeah, cool. Standard convention. This is new. The humans being trapped in this. Actually, well, seeing them together. We saw them being, like, attacked in Paris last time, I think. Like, being snatched, which was pretty good. Wasn't this already a movie? It was an old trailer that never came out because it got delayed. So now it finally is being bought by Netflix and coming out in 2 weeks. Do I make a review on this? This is barely gonna get out by the time I need to. I'll work it out. Right, what else is there to see? Everyone's freaked, so they actually see it and freak out. I imagine this isn't even, I mean, it could be the finale location, but I have like a sneaking suspicion it isn't. I don't know. I feel like they might go off somewhere else at that point. Here's them early on enjoying. I bet he's like, I'm gonna teach you how to build a fix a tire. Like my old dad taught me. Yeah. Kinda feels like it's full of cliches almost, but that should be my way of reading it. Uh-oh. Our first example of artifacting. This looks like I saw this as well. This seems more like a kind of ender game or a location. Because maybe at this point they saw the humans, ran away, and then they got cornered. Because like literally, well, they are in a technology shop, so I guess that makes sense. I like this joke. The change in name, especially. Good stuff. Breaking the camera, getting in fight, winning the day. He gets caught. Oh. But he's supportive of his daughter. Spoiled at the end of the trailer, right?
Yeah, that's the end of the trailer. That's the end of his arc. Wow. All right. They get the gun. They do the saving. Then he gets caught, I guess. They have the couple good guys that we... Like, the one that they're riding on is a good guy robot, hence the face.
I've always been weird.
Oh, hey, that's their neighbors. That's the perfect people, I think. Well, they're all in white, at least. All right, okay.
And that's what makes us great.
Again, they're playing super hot. That's literally just super hot. Also, by the way, I can do this at free will. That might be a little loud. Sorry about that. A lot of trailers spoil the climax of movies, which I don't like. Oh, yeah, I get it. I guess for this one, they didn't intend to make this version. Maybe. Like, it was gonna just probably be the... I don't know. It is a bit of a boo from me, you know? Can you do a review of Jojo Rabbit, the World War II film? Put it in our Discord video chats and I will add it to my list. But we'll see on that one. It is... I do like Taika Waititi, so we'll see. Anyway. Yep, this is them, what is this? Yeah, so when does this happen? Second.
What's a Furby?
Ooh. Okay, so it's when they first come. This looks like the same place that all the technology was showed up in. So where was the Furby before? Why has it got lasers? I'll never know. Yeah, there isn't really many secrets to that. Although, where did the big Furby go in, like, the big super shot? You know? Where was this? Also, the DMCA-able music is great for me. Like, yeah, where'd the Furby go? Did they destroy the Furby? Is it a separate thing? Was it edited out? No idea. Oh, thank you. Enjoy the 20 pence. I shall do, Woody. Where is my alert box? You are there? Why don't you do? Did you guys hear an alert box? I certainly didn't. Test a widget. Test me some bits. Okay, well, I heard that. That's me just making my own. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's going on with that. But all right, I need to change that GIF. That's a little outdated by now. Oh, well. That was Mitchell's versus the Machines. That's coming out surprisingly soon, which is a real surprise from me. The biggest surprise really is the fact that they changed the title. I'm excited about it. Hey, thank you for testing out my follower thing. Maybe me testing actually fixed it. Welcome. Thank you for the follow, Samuel. But yeah, I'm excited for that movie. In 2 weeks' time, maybe I'll watch it. It's a shame what happened to it. I'm excited to see what they do next, because Sony Pictures are making potentially R-rated animations afterwards. They're making a one about a dog and getting neutered, so we'll see how that turns out. Yeah. Shall we move on? We have less than half an hour to our next segment. So at this point, I'm not planning to do much of an analysis. Not that that was much of an analysis. I'm just going to watch stuff, all right? So speaking of Netflix, I think this is also a Netflix thing. We have this thing that has popped up. I don't know if this will be my thing. Find out. It's called Army of the Dead. It's got a, yeah, Drax in it. Yeah. I enjoy me a zombie flick still. Mostly because I didn't watch all of Walking Dead because it's too gory. Zack Snyder is good right now. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring. At the window, nice, nice. they didn't say Justice League. Fine. And he began to speak. He said, you guys know this? You saw the bit of this trailer, it's not your vibe? Okay. I should probably keep talking for the sake of DMCA, honestly. Which is a bit of a pain when you're trying to do movie content live on Twitch, but you know, I do what I can. It sounds very American so far. And if it is, you know, well, actually, it's Army of the Dead. So I assume this is zombies, right? How glorious does this get, by the way? In the vault beneath the strip. Is that a heist movie? Our window to are they just really out. Wanting to delay the cool bit? Are they supposed to be like villains and they're dead, so they're the Army of the Dead? I know nothing, clearly. I mean, yeah, it's apocalypse. The Las Vegas is broken down. Show me the zombies. There we go. Oh, proper crowd pleasing. Well, just proper crowd.
What the
work. That wasn't that good of a money shot. He just had red teeth and red eyes.
They're not what you think they are. They're smarter.
Ah.
They're faster.
Cool. Oh, okay. Good, smart, organized zombies? I think I can get behind, honestly. The only thing throwing me off is if it's R-rated. But yeah, you know, zombie... if there's one way you can make zombies new, make them smart. That seems like a Dead Rising kind of level of cartoony. Dying, surrounded by money. Very fitting. This could actually be really... Maybe this is my vibe.
What is this?
Zombie tiger. I'm less into random zombie tigers. That guy's shooting poorly. Like, he's not even shooting down at them. But no, that's like Guardians of the Galaxy kind of deal. Well, maybe not quite, but you know, that high-end, fun, R-rated, of course. May 21st. Everything's coming out now? That's quick. My goodness. If you like smart zombies, watch World War Z. Yeah, I've heard that. I'll get around to it. I was really into Train to Busan. Not necessarily smart zombies, but like, I don't know. Not into Walking Dead. I got lost after the end of season 2, you know? But this looks good, in a sense. Like, it's kind of more like the video game approach. Like, I definitely get like Dead Rising vibes. Obviously, you gotta have your celeb up front and center. I liked the goofiness that was coming in later. It's nice to see like this just looks so... It looks like Left 4 Dead. This could be a Left 4 Dead shot, you know? Where it's just instead of clowns, it's Elvis Presley. I really like that. Whether I'll watch it because it's R-rated, we'll see. Depends how much they like, you know, dismembering limbs. But we'll see from that point, I guess, you know? One of those final shots reminded me of the Back 4 Blood poster. I've seen Back 4 Blood, the game. I don't remember the poster. Wouldn't it just been like the ground? Because actually, hold on. Is there literally 4 of them? Maybe not, no. No, it's like way more than 4. I was going to say, that's like a Left 4 Dead setup and everything. Yeah, I don't know what that last shot. Maybe that, like a big scope out. I don't remember very well. But yeah, no, that I'm actually interested. I didn't think I would be. I remember seeing like, oh, here's Zack Snyder's new thing. And I'm like, cool. I saw Justice League. I'm a little Zack Snyder'd out, but maybe I'm not. I feel like this feels more like a James Gunn production to me. But that's because I know nothing about directors. Great movie content creator I am. You're weirdly enough, you're fine with blood, but when it comes to bones starting to poke out, that's when you become queasy. Yeah, absolutely. Fine with blood. Not fine with, like, innards being outards. So... Is there a gore reviewer, a gore, like, to say, oh, does this have bone in it? Does this have intestines? And does this have a dismemberment or a decapitation? It's this level of R-rated. You don't want to see this. Go watch, the Rugrats instead. I don't know. Speaking of, let's watch the Rugrats trailer. I'm joking, it's not. It's, actually James Gunn. So I really should have made that joke. Oh, well. Suicide Squad. They've brought out an old trailer? New trailer? It's a different trailer. I figured I'd give it a watch. I didn't watch the last Suicide Squad trailer. Because everyone already had at that point.
What's it like?
Give it a go.
Living life is a punchline. But all it would take would be one blessed act of rebellion.
I do not know the characters of DC. I'm not a DC fanboy. I'm not even a Marvel fanboy, actually. I don't know characters that aren't on shows before.
You know the deal. Complete the mission.
So seeing where this goes is
You fail to follow my orders in any way, and I detonate the explosive device in the base of your skull.
I like Sharkman. You know, I love the colors. I love the costumes in this. I love the goofy. That's my type. As much as I'm enjoying the R-rated Mortal Kombat in concept, and this is another R-rated movie,
we're all gonna die.
I hope so.
I like the goofy.
Oh, for God's sake.
I like the spotty man the most so far. Although I'll probably like John Cena character. Don't know what they do. I mean, I know what she does. But like, this looks like just a nice bit of fun. But I'm just gonna cut away real quick then. Oh, he's got explosive spots. That's awesome. What's his name? I think I remember researching this before, but I don't remember. Mr. Spotty. Ooh. I can do with that kind of detaching lens. Mr. Rayman over here. Oh. Wait, were they just killing their own guy? Why were they attacking the shark? All right, there is a little bit of R-rated gore in this trailer. That, no warning, that's fine. Any blood.
Oh, yeah.
I kind of feel sad for the dude. They're dying. Save the world. My final message.
Here's the deal. We fail the mission. You die.
If we find out any information,
this scene does not win me over, though. I like the character. The actor? Peter Capaldi? Ah, they got it. Cut it off in half. At least that's good. Alright. I am interested in it for, like, the visual sake, Suicide Squad. Not invested in the story. It sounds like a, you know, kind of a repeat number two. Curious to see what, you know, Capaldi's gonna be doing. I'm interested in the characters more than anything. I like this guy. Wanna see what he does. You know? I like Bald Man Capaldi, wherever he's disappeared to. That's a, well, I wouldn't say it's a good look on him, but it looks like a comic character. I like Mr. Shark back here. I like them, well, I don't like them all, but I'm a bit of an outsider when it comes to DC, you know, I've only, like, yeah, no, I didn't see Man of Steel, I didn't see Wonder Woman, didn't see, the other one, what was it, Aquaman, saw, didn't see Justice League, saw the new Justice League, saw Batman v Superman, and then saw random Batman renditions, didn't even see Suicide Squad. I'm a bad DC fan, so I'm not a DC fan, I'm just a normie who doesn't watch films if they're in 2017. So I missed them all. But yes, they did already make Suicide Squad. This is a replacement, not a remake, not a remaster. It's got the same name, so that the Google search looks better. I don't know. This is like a less colorful Guardians of the Galaxy. I guess, but I mean, you know, pretty colorful sometimes, you know? It doesn't have, like, the golden sky space world of Guardians of the Galaxy, but considering they're just on Earth, I mean, like, I guess that was a, I guess it's a little lower down, but, like, at least costume-wise, it's as colorful as they can get, I would hope. Well, yeah, right, like, not many more, yeah, maybe it is a little washed out. I want more color now, I think about it. The colorblind dude, I demand more color. Let's see. The quickest remake in history? Yeah, it was very quick. I'll definitely agree with you on that. Ah, well, I'll let Suicide Squad do its thing, and I'll probably watch it, because that's my career now. Even if I'm not into, well, to be fair, yeah, I've made a career out of watching things I don't want to watch. This comes out August 6th, so, I'll make a note of this afterwards. I'm not making them right now. Let's see. Hopefully I'll be able to watch that in cinemas. August? We'll see. Right, moving on. We have another trailer. Actually, we have 15 minutes left. So I might actually... I have a 5-minute short I wanted to watch. I might just skip it. Do it another day. Or I'll tell you what I can do. I'll use it for a thumbnail. Clickbait. There you go. That's why I wanted it anyway. Look at all these wonderful things we could have watched. More, oh Jesus, more Sony in the form of Hotel Transylvania. Well, I think I got my thumbnail somewhere in there. Sure. All right then. actually, am I still gone? Whoops. Let's do that. Let's do that. There we go. Ain't that, there you go, fastest review in the West right there. Bam, we done the review. Is that going to be a 30-second video? should I make a clips channel? We'll see. Plenty of time to prepare, absolutely. The next segment might be a little wishy-washy, we will see, but whatever. Anyway, I found another trailer today while looking for trailers to add to this week's schedule. And here's one that's, as far as I can read it, Ryan Reynolds doing Ryan Reynolds thing. Have a look.
He has had a tremendous
I gotta
year.
Keep on talking. But it's a Ryan Reynolds movie. Doing Ryan Reynolds thing, I bet.
Is he a relative
what does he
of
do?
Yours?
God, no. Darius Kincaid, the hitman, wanted for like a zillion murders around the world.
And how often do you have this dream?
Just once.
Well, that's not
a night.
Right. I'm thinking you need to forget bodyguarding.
Can you hear that? By the way, because, oh, yes you can. It's just, I had to scroll down on Streamlabs. This just full on, like, I feel like the Ryan Reynolds thing's blurring together. This just looks like Deadpool when he's lying down to me, because it's Ryan Reynolds lying down. And he sounds like his friend from Deadpool in the pub, who's like, oh, you know, you look like this happened to a this thing.
A zillion murders around the world.
And how...
Anyway, this is indeed... The hitman's wife's bodyguard, apparently.
I didn't do this sooner.
I don't know necessarily what that means.
The world's been waiting for me to make this change.
Is this a sequel to a series? Is this its own separate thing?
This really feels like a new
Where's the wife? I haven't seen the trailer yet, so that's why.
Who are you?
The mafia took my husband.
Kill them.
We have to go get him.
No. I'm not getting involved in this. I'm under strict psychological orders.
So who's the hitman? He's the hitman?
Or is... my therapist. No bodyguard.
I truly should have paid more attention.
So that means no guns, no killing,
still,
and no
a dude that wants to be nice-ish.
What is he doing here?
In the middle of Free Guy, doing things in a non-violent way.
I'm on sabbatical.
That should have really shot.
How many times?
Samuel Jackson's the hitman. Okay. Oh yeah, I would have got it from that shot. But didn't?
We're trying to have a baby.
Didn't the wife just say they took my husband? You've got to come.
So lucky to have you as its host.
Oh man, this is like. And I'm trying to talk over the Britney bit so I don't get DMCA, damn it.
I, on the other hand, will tell you everything.
Yes, that, yeah, okay, so. Maybe that's fun. I just see Ryan Reynolds doing more Ryan Reynolds bits. You know, he's becoming a bit of a typecasted character. So, I'm never going to be fully invested in that because I'm going to have like a, Reynolds. You know? I don't know. Can't wait for the last movie in the trilogy. Oh, is that what it is? Oh, no. You're making a joke. Gotcha. I can't even tell. The hitman's wife's sister's son's friend's father's bodyguard. That will be a good sequel to eventually see. Absolutely. When does this one come out? It's got the same font as the last one. Is there some branding going on here? June 16th. Maybe people... Is that a new trend? Orange release dates? I don't know. It just makes me think we're in a world of fantasy. Anyway, who knows if this is reality. We have one final trailer that I found that I want to talk about. It is called Mainstream Trailer. I guess we'll get going then. It's R-rated as well? No, wait, what? It said R, but it's just pensive language, some graphic nudity. Alright, YouTube, don't cancel me when I try and play this on your system, on your site. Oh.
Who am I?
I can see the R rating and where it comes from. Those shoulders are looking at me very creepily, actually.
Life, Frankie?
I don't know.
Alright, what kind of stuff you want to make?
Oh, wow, okay. Just mash all together.
I want to make a next picture.
Two out of two celebrities so far.
What, now?
Yeah, right now.
Yo, what's up? Thanks for checking out this video.
Yes.
My little niece worships the
I remembered something about this trailer now.
Yo, why is my existence so lit?
It's called Mainstream. Because it's all about trending, you know, videography things.
You can't be following me. Like, I'm no one special, man.
Holy. Except, I don't know if you want to be the guy. I appear in person. Do you guys know what's coming up?
You want to be no one special.
This is the beginning.
Is this gonna strike close to my heart? Okay. I hope not.
Oh my God.
Okay, I thought that was Emma Stone then. I was like, whoa, hold on, what?
Good to see
it. Just my hope again.
or no phone?
I'm Charles Melton, and I'm
influencers
no
doing influencer
show.
Things.
Bad idea.
Even had YouTube in the corner.
No, this is just feeling so right because we're about to go stratospheric.
Uh-huh.
I see you, right?
See you.
Don't hurt her.
Love that, Jake.
Do influencers do that? Do they have like little driver things? Seems kind of lame. Don't hurt her.
Your success directly
I go. Now here's the thing I remember. This is what I know. Not you, buddy. I mean, sure, your face is interesting too. This is a Jake Paul movie. Or like a Jake Paul's in the cast. I don't know if he's producing. I don't know what's going on. It makes sense. It's on brand.
What's your message, does it not?
You tell viewers they're stupid.
Oh, no, all right. He's not just a cameo. Because you're getting swept up in the is there more to him?
Get the viewers back up before we lose any more.
A prophet will not be accepted.
So wait,
in
is this a
hometown.
Stage to lead the show, or is this a live stream? You can lose viewers. It's a stage show. Vomiting emotes. Thank you for the follow, Hellboy.
Have you told me one single thing that was true?
Yeah, I'm rich and famous, and I have loads of followers.
I'm no one special.
Cut.
You.
That was great.
That was horrible. That was hot. I felt deeply, deeply uncomfortable. But yeah! Alright. What am I looking at here? Where is Jake Paul's name? What did they do to him? What? Why? Like, why is he here? Is he just a, like he's not in the celebrity cast list? So it. anything else? No. All right. Well, that's just the people I got this trailer from. Excuse me there. Well, that's suddenly something. What's the release date on that one? Since we've done it with all the other ones, does it say? It doesn't. There is no release date from what I can see. Andrew Garfield, interesting to see. Maya Hawke, want to see more of her. I've only seen her from Stranger Things because I'm a normie. So it'd be cool to see more of her. I guess I'm interested to see where it goes, but yeah. What movie was that? It's called Mainstream. It's just called Mainstream. Is this going to be boomers against streamers? I don't know. It just looks like streamers against streamers, honestly. But it's a stage play. So I guess it's not an influencer doing like a convention stage play. And it's all like the build up to that. Like the documentary the Try Guys did. I don't know. I don't know what to expect. This seems like something. Although it's got Andrew Garfield. And Maya Hawke. So like it's got competent celebrities in it. So I can't make a terrible video out of it. I don't know what to expect, in all honesty. I'm just completely lost. I'm gonna be keeping an interesting eye. As much as it could be a disaster, when certain people are involved, sometimes you can't look away, you know? The dude looks like he's already getting a mugshot in a prison, you know? Just crop out, like, the suit's shoulder and this random denim corner. And, just make this background all pale grey. You'd think he's just gone to prison. But he also has a mic set up on him, because he would have that in prison. I don't know. I have no other thoughts to say. I'm just a little bit, like, confuzzled on it all, you know? Andrew Garfield has been under your radar for a while now, yeah. When you said under, I thought you first said under the radar, just under the radar for a while, and I'm like, dude's won awards. He's not under the radar. He's very big, very popular, you know? Not just only known for his Spider-Man thing 9 years ago. This is another social media bad, I swear to God. It looks like it could just be complex characters. Conflicted characters and people doing conflicted kind of things. I don't know. But anyway, it's at this point I need to... I won't have that music. It's fine. There is something I need to test for a moment. But for now, let's just go back to our regular chatting thing. If that's okay with you, I need to make some poking tweets. About things.
How's everybody? Sorry to interrupt. I've got things sorted out, coming together. It is now 9:02, so I'm starting to prepare for our next segment. Though it might take a moment to, you know, we've got all the growing pains to go through, so, you know, give us some awareness on, give us some time. We've got some things to sort out. But how is everybody? Da-da-da, that to go there. I need music. Can I just have like, yeah, there we go. That'll do. I'll let you listen. How is that volume? I'll check that in a minute as well, actually. I can listen to it now. How's it sound? Very quiet. Now, how's it sound? Hold on. Very, very quiet. You can barely hear it. Hold on. Love that. I guess I'll use the time to fix that as well.
You can barely hear it. Hold on. Love that.
How's that?
I guess I'll use the time everything. Sorry. I'm echoing myself so much. You're doing all right. It's midnight here and you'll be up till 3 a.m. Wow. That's crazy. That is probably about the time we'll be finishing stream. So thank you for your sacrifice. But man, you don't have to, well, I guess if you want to stay up till 3, you can do. I can't stop you, Abrams, or not Abrams, but, you know. Oh, whatever. Hello, Aaron the Pro, you didn't get an alert box for some reason. I don't know why. Hello, Aaron the Pro, you didn't get an alert box for some reason. I don't know why.
Cool.
Hello.
Sorry, I now have to redo that track one more time just to check the audio levels are fine. I'm sorry. Just the things I have to try and juggle all the time. We are only going to do these kind of errors the first time now because we're doing it for the first time. After this, it should hopefully all roll nicely together and I'll remember this, the details I've got and go from there. We're doing good, cha-cha-chi. What did you eat for breakfast today? Me? I had eggs, vegan sausages, bacon, mushrooms. I had a proper like protein breakfast, basically. I'm trying to cut out on red meat, so having vegan sausages, soon enough vegan bacon, just because red meat every day, kind of unhealthy. That's my own thing. He was literally able to glean nothing from the trailer. You were confused. Yeah, right? Well, I don't know. Whatever. You might mention this in the Discord. Uh-huh. A bit about the subreddit. I don't know. Oh, yeah. What, if we ever wanted our own subreddit? Still not into it just yet. We need to have a bigger community that's more memeable. And so far, it's very, very little on that front. So I'd rather have no subreddit than like a dead subreddit. Kind of my stance. Yeah. Now, on the topic of dead versus empty, I need to quickly make an adjustment. Tell me how this looks, because I'll explain in a moment, alright?